Good evening, everyone. Welcome to NEET PG Life Daily. Myself, Dr. Apurva Mittal, and we'll be discussing about obstetric anesthesia on this prestigious platform of An Academy, which is India's one of the leading platforms for online courses. So welcome to the class, friends. By getting the An Academy subscription plus, you'll be able to avail the live classes, also interact with the educators for all the 19 subjects. We'll be having live polls and leaderboard for the respective live quizzes, test series and analysis in which you can evaluate the progress, and also live doubt clearing sessions in which you can clear the doubts pertaining to the subject to the top educators. And the An Academy Plus subscription, you can get it either for a 12 months or a 24 months course. And if you apply my code, that is Apurva Life, that is APURVA Life, you can avail 10% discount for the same. So starting with our topic today, that is obstetric anesthesia. I hope I'm loud and clear. If any doubt, please let me know. So in obstetric anesthesia, first I'll talk about the physiological changes in pregnancy, in the various systems, the anesthesia is different. Okay, the anesthetic doses and certain precautions have to be taken per se in pregnant ladies. Okay, so this is because of these physiological changes that we have to make the adjustments in the dose and also the procedure while giving anesthesia to the pregnant ladies. Okay, so what is physiological changes in pregnancy in the central nervous system? See, in the central nervous system, the mean alveolar concentration for all the inhalational anesthetic, it progressively decreases. Okay, so pregnancy may the mean alveolar concentration, the minimum amount of the concentration of the inhalational anesthetic in the alveolar, it decreases as much as 40%. Now, why is it so? Because in pregnancy, the progesterone levels increases up to 20 times normal at the term. And this progesterone has a sedating effect when given in the pharmacological doses. So in the pregnancy, this progesterone level increases many folds. It increases by up to 20 times normal at the term. And therefore, the requirement of the minimum alveolar concentration of the inhalation anesthetic, it decreases. Okay, so this is why the MAC value decreases. Now, second important point is in pregnancy, we have to reduce the dose of the local anesthetics. Okay, we have to reduce the dose of local anesthetics. Okay, which is required to give the spinal or epidural anesthesia. Now, why is it so? This is very important. That is because pregnancy, it enhances sensitivity to the local anesthetic, and the neural blockade, it occurs at the reduced doses of local anesthetic. Okay, so from pregnancy, it enhances the sensitivity to the local anesthetic, and neural blockade, it occurs at a reduced dose of the local anesthetic, and we have to reduce as much as 30% of the local anesthetic dose. Now, why is it so? That is because the enlarging uterus, okay, the gravid uterus, it compresses the inferior vena cava, and also there is distension of the epidural venous plexus, which increases the epidural blood volume. Okay, so ek to ye dono factors ho gaye. So, because of the distending uterus, there is decrease in the spinal cerebral CSF volume, and also there is decreased potential volume of the epidural space. Okay, of the epidural space, and also there is increase in the epidural space pressure. Because of these features, ki jo space hoti hai, the space, the potential space in which we are giving our local anesthetic, that is only reduced, and also wahan ke jo venous plexus hota hai, that becomes more dilated. Theek hai? And therefore there are more chances of the cephalid spread of the local anesthetic, and therefore the dose of the local anesthetic should be reduced in case of the pregnant ladies. Okay, and because the epidural vessels, they become more venous distension is there, might be there are more chances of giving the okay, so till now what I discussed was the physiological changes in the pregnancy. Okay, the physiological changes in the pregnancy, I discussed about the changes in the CNS, that is the central nervous system. In the central nervous system, jo MAC hota hai, the minimum alveolar concentration, it progressively decreases. Okay, it progressively decreases, and it decreases. I'm just repeating because I think there was some problem in the net connection, so just let me just repeat with it. The central nervous system, the minimum alveolar concentration, that is the minimum amount of the inhalational anesthetic in the alveoli, which is required to knock off 50% of the patients to the surgical stimulus, that is the incision, is decreased as much as 40% for all the general anesthetic agents. Okay, and that is because the progesterone level, it is because of the increase in the progesterone level up to 20 times normal at term, which has a sedating effect even at the pharmacological doses. So it is increasing by about 20% in pregnancy. Okay, second important thing is in the pregnancy enhances the sensitivity to the local anesthetic. Okay, the local anesthetics which we use in the spinal and the epidural anesthesia, the sensitivity to it is increased in the pregnancy, and therefore we get the same amount of spinal or epidural anesthetic blockade at the reduced doses or concentration of the local anesthetic. Why is it so, friends? That is because the gravid uterus, is compresses upon the inferior vena cava. Okay, and also there is decreased spinal cerebral CSF volume. Also, the potential volume of the epidural space is decreased, and therefore we have to reduce the dose of the local anesthetic, which will bring the same effect, because as there is decrease in this volume and the space, there are more chances of the cephalid spread of the local anesthetic. Okay, and to prevent the complication of high spinal or total spinal, we should reduce the dose of local anesthetics in these patients, in the pregnant ladies. Also we see that there is distension of the epidural venous plexus and increase in the epidural blood volume. And while giving the local anesthesia intrathecally or epidural space, we might accidentally inject it into the intravascular space, leading to local anesthetic systemic toxicity. Is it clear, friends? Now the net connectivity is okay. Okay. So this was on the central nervous system. Now what about the respiratory effects? रेस्पिरेटरी इफेक्ट्स में देखा होगा प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज हर समय शैलो ब्रीदिंग लेती हैं, ठीक है। द प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज मोस्टली टेक द शैलो ब्रीदिंग एंड देयर इज टैकेपनिया। सी रेस्पिरेटरी इफेक्ट्स इज इन प्रेगनेंसी द ऑक्सीजन कंजम्पशन and minute ventilation, that is the tidal volume into the respiratory rate, it increases progressively. The oxygen consumption and the minute ventilation, it increases progressively. Okay, as the minute ventilation is increasing, that means tidal volume and respiratory rate is also increasing. Okay, and also the PaCO2 level, ठीक है, hyperventilate कर रही है, हाइपर वेंटिलेट करेंगी तो PaCO2 लेवल क्या होगा, इट विल डिक्रीज, ठीक है। हाइपर वेंटिलेशन शैलो ब्रीदिंग से क्या होगा, शैलो ब्रीदिंग से क्या होगा, द PaCO2 लेवल इट डिक्रीजेस एंड देयर इज चांसेस ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी अल्कलोसिस, बट दिस इज प्रिवेंटेड बिकॉज देयर इज ऑल्सो अ डिक्रीज इन द प्लाज्मा बाइकार्बोनेट लेवल। तो रेस्पिरेटरी इफेक्ट में हम लोग अगर याद रखेंगे, सो वी शुड रिमेंबर दैट दे हैव शैलो ब्रीदिंग, द प्रेगनेंट लेडीज हैव शैलो ब्रीदिंग, इसी से याद आ जाएगा, दैट इज द मिनट वेंटिलेशन, ओके, द रेस्पिरेटरी रेट एंड द टाइडल वॉल्यूम इट इंक्रीजेस, ओके, and there is more of the oxygen consumption. Now also the functional residual capacity, the functional residual capacity, that is the that is the amount of air which is remaining in the lungs after normal expiration, okay, amount of air remaining in lungs after normal expiration, ठीक है, normal expiration, that is the functional residual capacity, it decreases up to 20%. Now what is the anesthetic implication of it? If the FRC is decreasing, how does it affect us? That is because there is more needed, as the FRC is needed, there is more need of the pre-oxygenation or denitrogenation prior to induction of the general anesthesia to avoid hypoxemia in pregnant patients. As FRC, in other words, as FRC decreases to prevent hypoxemia, it is more important to pre-oxygenate the patient before giving the general anesthetic, because as there is decrease in the FRC, wo jaldi se desaturate ho jayenge, there is rapid oxygen desaturation, ठीक है, बिकॉज द एफ आर सी इज डिक्रीज, देयर इज रैपिड ऑक्सीजन डिसैचुरेशन ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड ऑफ एपनिया एंड देयरफॉर इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू प्री ऑक्सीजनेट द प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज। इज इट क्लियर? द रेस्पिरेटरी में द मिनट वेंटिलेशन, द टाइडल वॉल्यूम, बोथ ऑफ देम आर इंक्रीजिंग, द ऑक्सीजन कंजम्पशन इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग, बट द एफ आर सी इज डिक्रीजिंग एंड the rapid oxygen desaturation can occur in pregnant ladies, and therefore it is very important to pre-oxygenate them. Okay, now as there is decrease in the FRC, okay, and increase in the minute ventilation, FRC decrease ho raha hai, but increase in minute ventilation, toh kya hoga? Anesthetic, the inhaled anesthetics which we are given, there is accelerated uptake of all the inhaled anesthetics, okay, there is accelerated uptake of all the inhaled anesthetics. So these are the respiratory physiological changes which occur in pregnancy. Because of the progesterone, there is capillary engorgement, okay, of the respiratory mucosa, ठीक है, पूरा कैपिलरी इंगॉर्जमेंट हो जाता है, इवन द एयर वेज दे आर लिटिल बिट स्वेलन एंड देयर फॉर मोर चांसेस ऑफ ट्रॉमा टू द अपर एयर वे ड्यूरिंग लैरिंगोस्कोपी. देयरफॉर द लैरिंगोस्कोपी शुड बी वेरी स्मूथ एंड वी शुड यूज स्मॉलर साइज एंडोट्रेकियल ट्यूब इन केसेस ऑफ द प्रेगनेंट लेडीज टू प्रिवेंट ट्रॉमा ब्लीडिंग एंड ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. इज इट क्लियर फ्रेंड्स? Is it clear? So this is the capillary engorgement and this is the respiratory changes which occur during the pregnancy. Okay, now these were the respiratory changes. Now coming to the cardiovascular changes. The cardiovascular systemic changes is also very important. See, pregnant ladies may one term is known as dilutional anemia occurs. ठीक है, एंड ऑल्सो एक तो ये और दूसरा ड्यूरिंग डिलीवरी देर इज लॉस ऑफ ब्लड. नॉर्मल डिलीवरी में अराउंड 500, सिजेरियन में अराउंड 1000 ml ऑफ ब्लड इज लॉस. So to compensate for this loss, the cardiac output increases. So in the pregnant ladies, we see that there is increase in the cardiac output by 40% at term. And cardiac output is equal to heart rate into stroke volume. That means my stroke volume is also increasing by 30% and heart rate is also increasing by 20% to bring about the increase in the cardiac output. Okay, the next question that can be asked is when is the greatest increase in the cardiac output seen? So the greatest increase in the cardiac output occurs during the labor. The greatest increase in the cardiac output, it occurs during the labor or immediately after, okay, the delivery of the baby. Okay, it occurs immediately after the delivery of the baby. So the maximum increase in the cardiac output is seen immediately after the delivery of the baby, and this is the question asked. Now what is dilutional anemia? Dilutional anemia is the plasma volume it is increasing by 55%. And the increase in the red cell mass is only 45%. Okay, the plasma volume to 55% increase ho raha hai, jabki red cell mass is increasing by 45%. So the increase in the plasma volume is in excess to the increase in the red cell volume, and therefore there is dilutional anemia. And also reduction in the viscosity. Is it clear? Okay, so this is the cardiovascular system mein ek to dilutional anemia ho raha hai aur also increase in the cardiac output. Now very important syndrome is seen in the pregnant ladies. What happens is the gravid uterus, theek hai, after 20 weeks of प्रेगनेंसी, ये जो यूट्रस होता है उसका साइज इंक्रीज हो रहा है ना, तो इट कंप्रेसेस द इंफीरियर वेना कैवा. अब इंफीरियर वेना कैवा अगर कंप्रेस होगा तो क्या होगा, वीनस रिटर्न विल डिक्रीज एंड देयर इज डिक्रीज इन द प्रीलोड दैट विल डिक्रीज द कार्डियक आउटपुट. So, supine hypotension syndrome, supine, सीधे लेटने पे, there is hypotension in pregnancy. Why? There is a decrease in the cardiac output. That is, can occur in the supine position after 20 weeks of pregnancy. And this is secondary. Why does it occur? Because of the impeded venous return to the heart. As why? Because the uterus is compressing on the IVC. See this figure, friend. ये gravid uterus है, ये ग्रेविड यूट्रस है, ठीक है। दिस इज द इन्फीरियर वेना कैवा, ये जो ब्लू कलर का है इट इज द इन्फीरियर वेना कैवा। नाउ दिस ग्रेविड यूट्रस, इट अगर पेशेंट सीधी लेटी हुई है, इट कंप्रेसेस द इन्फीरियर वेना कैवा एंड देयरफॉर द क्रीज एंड द कार्डिक आउटपुट विल बी डिक्रीज एंड देयर विल बी हाइपोटेंशन। नाउ If I ask the lady to lie in the lateral position, in the right lateral position, ठीक है, right lateral position पे क्या होगा? Uterus आगे को, it will fall, okay, and it won't compress the inferior vena cava and the aorta and the venous return will be maintained and the cardiac output will be maintained and therefore the pregnant ladies are advised not to lie straight on the back, they are always advised कि कभी भी सीधा मत लेटना, हर समय करवट लेके, always either to the right or the left lateral position, that is the best position for the pregnant ladies to lie and that is to prevent the supine hypotension syndrome. Okay, so 5% of the women at term develop supine hypotension syndrome. अब क्या होता है? If I have to give regional anesthesia, if I have to give spinal anesthesia, okay, regional anesthesia in a pregnant ladies, ठीक है, in pregnant ladies, तो spinal anesthesia क्या करता है? Spinal का क्या होता है? Because of sympatholytic effect, ये क्या करता है? When I am giving this spinal anesthesia, there is peripheral pooling of blood because of sympathectomy and there is venodilation, peripheral pooling is in the cardiac output. So both these effects, they have additive effects. Ek to supine hypotension syndrome, upar se spinal anesthesia, the cardiac output will decrease a lot and that can cause hypotension and therefore during spinal anesthesia or at term lady is always asked to lie in the lateral decubitus position or else, ठीक है, or else, see, as I have written, it is characterized by hypotension associated with pallor, sweating, nausea and vomiting and when it is combined with the hypotensive effects of regional anesthesia, there might be a large amount of decrease in the cardiac output which can produce the fetal hypoxia and therefore to prevent this, we ask the pregnant lady to lie on her side. When the pregnant lady lies on her side, it will restore the venous return from the lower part of the body and it will correct the hypotension. How else it can be prevented is by placing a wedge. Okay, ek wedge rakh diya under the right hip. Okay, by placing a wedge under the right hip can also prevent the supine hypotension syndrome. Is it clear? Is it clear, friends? Okay, so this is about the supine hypotension syndrome. These were the CVS effect. So CVS mein we saw the cardiac output is increased and also there is dilutional anemia which is seen because the plasma volume is increasing in access to the red cell volume. Now what about the renal effects? See friends, renal plasma flow and the GFR, it both increases. ठीक है, इट बोथ इंक्रीज. गैस्ट्रो इंटेस्टाइनल सिस्टम में हम लोगों ने देखा होगा द प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज दे आर मोर प्रोन फॉर गैस्ट्रो इसोफेजियल रिफ्लक्स डिसीज और इसोफेजाइटिस. ठीक है, प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज को बहुत ज्यादा एसिडिटी की प्रॉब्लम होती है. देर आर मोर चांसेस ऑफ GERD और इसोफेजाइटिस इन द प्रेगनेंसी. व्हाई इज इट सो? This is because of two factors. See, first of all, the gastric motility is reduced in the pregnant ladies. Okay, the gastric motility is reduced in the pregnant ladies, and also because the gravid uterus, ठीक है, ग्रेविड यूट्रस क्या करता है, इट कॉजेस द अपवर्ड एंड एंटीरियर डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ द स्टमक, ठीक है, ओके. गैस्ट्रिक मोटिलिटी इज रिड्यूस. ऑल्सो ग्रेविड यूट्रस इट कॉजेस द स्टमक टू मूव अपवर्ड एंड एंटीरियर, ठीक है, एंड ऑल्सो द टोन ऑफ द लोअर इसोफेजियल स्फिंक्टर इज रिड्यूस्ड. ठीक है, सो बिकॉज द ग्रेविड यूट्रस इट कॉजेस अपवर्ड एंड एंटीरियर डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ द स्टमक बाय द यूट्रस, एंड ऑल्सो बिकॉज ऑफ द इंक्रीज इन द प्रोजेस्टेरॉन द टोन ऑफ द लोअर इसोफेजियल स्फिंक्टर इज रिड्यूस्ड, एंड देयरफॉर मोर चांसेस ऑफ गैस्ट्रिक एस्पिरेशन, more commonly the gastroesophageal reflux occurs in pregnancy. Is it clear? ठीक है, so GERD and esophagitis, because increase in the progesterone level it will reduce the tone of the lower esophageal sphincter, and also the gravid uterus it displaces the stomach and the esophagus are anteriorly and upward, and therefore more chances of GERD. दूसरी, सो जो प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज हैं, प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज आर ऑलवेज कंसिडर्ड अ फुल स्टमक, ठीक है, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इज ऑलवेज कंसिडर्ड एज अ फुल स्टमक, ओके. The fasting guidelines for the pregnant ladies is same. That is for the clear liquids like water or apple juice or the pulp-free juices, it is advised or they can take it up to 2 hours before the procedure. And the milk, okay, non-human milk or the light meal, they can take it till 6 hours before the procedure. Heavy meals should be stopped 8 hours before the procedure. But after these fasting guidelines also, because of the effect of the progesterone and the gravid uterus, the pregnant ladies are always considered as the full stomach. Okay, now there is one term or syndrome which is known as the Mendelsohn syndrome. Okay, there is one syndrome which is known as the Mendelsohn syndrome. It is more common in pregnancy. Now what is Mendelsohn syndrome? Okay, what is Mendelsohn syndrome? It is, first of all, it is more common in pregnancy because of these physiological changes, and it is nothing but it is a chemical pneumonia. Okay, chemical pneumonia which is caused by aspiration of the gastric juice during anesthesia and intubation. Okay, so the aspiration of the gastric juice, because they are considered as full stomach, more chances of aspiration. The aspiration of the gastric juice into the lungs can cause chemical pneumonia, and that syndrome is known as the Mendelsohn syndrome. Now what are the risk factors for this Mendelsohn syndrome? Yeah, there are 2.5 and 25. That is, the if the pH of the aspirated fluid is less than 2.5, or the volume of the aspirate is more than 25 ml in the adults, there are more chances of getting the Mendelsohn syndrome. ठीक है, नाउ दोस्त वर द रिस्क फैक्टर्स समझ में आ गया, दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द एस्पिरेशन ऑफ द गैस्ट्रिक कंटेंट्स. अब जब गैस्ट्रिक कंटेंट्स एस्पिरेट होते, व्हाट दे डू इज दे कॉज सीवियर इन्फ्लेमेटरी चेंजेस. ठीक है, दे कॉज द सीवियर इन्फ्लेमेटरी चेंजेस इन द लंग पैरेन्काइमा. ठीक है, एंड ऑल्सो दे विल प्रीडिस्पोज टू द इन्फेक्शन. Okay, so there is severe inflammatory changes, and also they predispose to the infection. And patient jo hai, after aspiration, generally within 30 minutes, the patient complains of the respiratory distress. That is, there is rapid breathing, wheeze and cough, and also tachypnea and tachycardia can occur. And also tachypnea and tachycardia can occur. So these are this is what happens in Mendelssohn syndrome. Okay, Mendelssohn syndrome, the chemical pneumonia, which is because of the aspiration of the gastric contents. Okay, risk factors mein pH agar less than 2.5 hai, ya fir उसका जो वॉल्यूम है इट इज मोर देन 25 ml, उसकी वजह से एस्पिरेशन ऑफ द गैस्ट्रिक कंटेंट्स, वो सीवियर इन्फ्लेमेटरी चेंजेस करेंगे एंड पेशेंट इज मोर प्रोन फॉर इन्फेक्शन. नाउ हाउ कैन आई प्रिवेंट इट? सी, या तो मैं पीएच को इंक्रीज कर दूं, ठीक है, पीएच को इंक्रीज कर दूं, या फिर गैस्ट्रिक मोटिलिटी इंक्रीज कर दूं. ठीक है, तो पीएच को कैसे कर सकते हैं वो, या फिर गैस्ट्रिक कंटेंट को कम कर दूं. तो इसीलिए ऑलवेज एडिक्वेट प्री ऑपरेटिव स्टार्वेशन शुड बी ऑलवेज डन. ठीक है, प्री ऑपरेटिव स्टार्वेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू इंक्रीज द मोटिलिटी. द प्रोकाइनेटिक एजेंट्स लाइक मेटोक्लोप्रोमाइड कैन बी गिवन एंड टू द पीएच. ठीक है, pH of the gastric contents, ठीक है, उसको increase करने के लिए I can give H2 receptor blockers like ranitidine, Now, there is one more term which is very important, and that term is known as rapid sequence induction. Okay, and that is known as rapid sequence induction. In this, what happens is, see friends, during anesthesia, जब हम लोग general anesthesia देते हैं, what is the protocol? We give the pre-anesthetic medications, then we give the inhalational agents. After that, we give the positive pressure ventilation. है ना? We give the positive pressure ventilation. ठीक है, वी प्री ऑक्सीजनेट द पेशेंट फॉर 3 मिनट्स बाय गिविंग पॉजिटिव प्रेशर वेंटिलेशन एंड आफ्टर दैट वी गिव द मसल रिलैक्सेंट. सी, नॉर्मली नॉर्मल पेशेंट्स में अपन ने पहले प्री एनेस्थेटिक मेडिकेशन दिया, ठीक है, फिर हम लोग इनहलेशनल एजेंट्स देते हैं, इंड्यूसिंग, फिर हम लोग उसको इंड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स देते हैं, ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद हम लोग उसको प्री ऑक्सीजनेट करते हैं बाय पॉजिटिव प्रेशर वेंटिलेशन एंड देन वी गिव मसल रिलैक्सिंग. ठीक है, मसल रिलैक्सिंग, उसके बाद भी हम प्री ऑक्सीजनेट करते रहते हैं, उसको पॉजिटिव प्रेशर देते रहते हैं एंड देन we intubate the patient once muscle relaxant activity has come. Now, in rapid sequence induction, ये जो positive pressure ventilation होता है, ये इससे क्या होता है? Some air, ठीक है, goes into the esophagus also, and there are more chances of aspiration. The chances of aspiration it increases. ठीक है, रैपिड सीक्वेंस इंडक्शन में हम लोग क्या करें, रैपिड सीक्वेंस इंडक्शन उसमें क्या करें, प्री एनेस्थेटिक एजेंट दिया, इंड्यूसिंग एजेंट दिया, वी प्री ऑक्सीजनेट, बट वी डोंट गिव इन RSI, वी डोंट गिव द पॉजिटिव प्रेशर वेंटिलेशन. ठीक है, वी डायरेक्टली गिव द मसल रिलैक्सिंग एंड देन इंट्यूबेट द पेशेंट. So when I'm not giving this positive pressure ventilation, I'm reducing the chances of aspiration. Okay? Secondly, in rapid sequence induction, there is a maneuver which is known as the Selix maneuver. There's a maneuver known as the Selix maneuver. See, ek to Selix maneuver kya hai? I'm applying pressure. Okay? Application of pressure on the cricoid cartilage, ठीक है, such that ये जो esophagus है, ठीक है, esophagus है, cricoid cartilage पे ऐसे pressure लगाओ कि ये जो esophagus है इसकी opening constrict हो जाए. ठीक है, the esophageal opening gets constricted. Okay, so सेलिक्स मैन्यूवर में जैसे ही मैंने इंड्यूसिंग एजेंट दिया, ठीक है, व्हेन आई एम गिविंग द इंड्यूसिंग एजेंट एट दैट टाइम ओनली आई विल स्टार्ट कंप्रेसिंग द सिकॉइड कार्टिलेज अगेंस्ट द इसोफेगस सो दैट अगेंस्ट द इसोफेगस ठीक है अगेंस्ट द इसोफेगस सो दैट द ओपनिंग इज कंस्ट्रिक्टेड ठीक है ओपनिंग इज कंस्ट्रिक्टेड एंड दिस प्रेशर इज मेंटेन्ड इट इज मेंटेन्ड टिल आई इंट्यूबेट द पेशेंट टिल द पेशेंट इज इंट्यूबेटेड ठीक है एंड द कफ इज इन्फ्लेटेड द कफ ऑफ द ईटी ट्यूब इट इज इन्फ्लेटेड टिल दैट टाइम अ कॉन्स्टेंट pressure, required pressure is applied against the esophagus to prevent the aspiration of the gastric contents. ठीक है and this pressure is around 40 newtons. This pressure is around 30 to 40 newtons. ठीक है so by this Selig's maneuver it is applied in cases of the pregnant ladies or the trauma or where the full stomach or chances of aspiration is more in that I'll just compress this cricoid cartilage against the esophagus okay well this pressure will be started when I'm giving the inducing agent don't pre-oxygenate the patient and this pressure should only be released after intubating the patient and after the cuff has been inflated because cuff of the ET tube the main function of it is to prevent aspiration once the cuff is inflated the chances of aspiration reduces and therefore I can remove the pressure okay this is what is known as the Selig's maneuver is it clear now pregnancy it is a hypercoagulable state ठीक है प्रेगनेंसी इट इज अ हाइपर कोआगुलेबल स्टेट बिकॉज इन दिस द कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ द फाइब्रिनोजन एंड कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ द फैक्टर्स लाइक 7, 8, 9, 10 and 12 ऑल इंक्रीजेस सो याद रखना प्रेगनेंसी इज अ हाइपर कोआगुलेबल स्टेट प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज में डीवीटी होने के चांसेस काफी ज्यादा हैं एंड देयरफॉर वी ऑलवेज आस्क देम टू कीप ऑन मूविंग स्पेशली अगर वो लॉन्ग ट्रैवल करे वी ऑलवेज आस्क देम टू कीप हाइड्रेटेड एंड कीप मूविंग ठीक है दे बिकॉज द चांसेस ऑफ द डीप वेन थ्रोम्बोसिस इज वेरी हाई इन प्रेगनेंसी बिकॉज इट इज अ हाइपर कोआगुलेबल स्टेट इज इट क्लियर ठीक है नाउ This was the obstetric, the physiological changes in pregnancy. So, because of the physiological changes, we saw. अभी तक हम लोगों ने जब पढ़ा, अगर देखा जाए तो regional anesthesia में हम लोगों को the dose of the local anesthetic should be reduced. The dose of the local anesthetic should be reduced. General anesthesia mein, we saw that ek to uska fasting should be adequate. ठीक है always give antacids should always be given to prevent the aspiration. ठीक है RSI should be done, Selig's maneuver should be done, and because हम लोगों ने पढ़ा था, there is a capillary engorgement, more chances of trauma, laryngoscopy, and should be gentle, and ETT tube size should be decreased around 6 to 6.5 mm internal diameter tube should only be used in the pregnant ladies to prevent the trauma and also the dose of the inhalational agents should be decreased because the MAC value decreases by around 40% in the pregnant ladies. Also, ekor in regional anesthesia, take care of supine hypotension. सिंड्रोम। इज इट क्लियर? तो अभी तक बिकॉज ऑफ द फिजियोलॉजिकल चेंजेस दीज फीचर्स हैज टू बी केप्ट इन माइंड व्हाइल गिविंग एनेस्थीसिया टू द प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज नाउ कमिंग टू द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट अबाउट लेबर एनल्जीजिया व्हाई लेबर एनल्जीजिया इज एक्चुअली नीडेड। ठीक है, लेबर एनल्जीजिया एक तो कंफर्ट ऑफ द पेशेंट तो है ही, बट इज देयर एनी अदर एडवांटेज ऑफ गिविंग लेबर एनल्जीजिया? दैट इज फर्स्ट सी द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द लेबर पेन। ठीक है, एन इफेक्ट ऑफ लेबर पेन ऑन द मदर एंड द चाइल्ड सो दैट वी विल कम टू नो अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ लेबर एनल्जीजिया। सी जो यूट्राइन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन हो रहा है ड्यूरिंग द लेबर पेन, देयर इज यूट्राइन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन। दिस यूट्राइन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन कैन रिजल्ट इन द मायोमेट्रियल इस्कीमिया। ठीक है, द यूट्राइन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन इट मेट रिजल्ट इन द मायोमेट्रियल इस्कीमिया। बिकॉज ऑफ दिस देयर इज रिलीज ऑफ ब्रैडीकाइनिन, हिस्टामिन एंड सेरोटोनिन एंड देयरफॉर देयर इज पेन। ठीक है, therefore there is pain. This is one thing because of the uterus contraction. Why there is pain? Because there is myometrial ischemia and there is release of the bradykinin, histamine and serotonin. Okay, also there is stretching and distension, stretching and distension of the lower uterine segment and cervix. Okay, and this will stimulate the mechanoreceptors and therefore there is pain. So mechanism of labor pain do jagah tarike se, because of the uterine contraction and also the distension or stretching of the lower uterine segment and the cervix. So because of these two things the pregnant lady experiences pain. Now jab painful uterine contractions ho rahe hain, theek hai, the painful uterine contractions hote hain uske wajah se maternal hyperventilation ho raha hai. अब मैटरनल हाइपर वेंटिलेशन हो रहा है तो क्या होगा? PCO2 डिक्रीज होगा, सो देयर इज हाइपोकार्बिया। ठीक है, हाइपोकार्बिया रिजल्ट्स इन हाइपर वेंटिलेशन बिटवीन द कॉन्ट्रैक्शंस। ठीक है, क्योंकि कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड कम हो रहा है तो रेस्पिरेटरी डिप्रेशन होगा, दिस विल लीड टू हाइपो वेंटिलेशन बिटवीन द कॉन्ट्रैक्शंस एंड दिस माइट रिड्यूस द फीटल ऑक्सीजन डिलीवरी and this might reduce the fetal oxygen delivery. And also if I see the oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve, okay, because of the maternal hyperventilation, the hypocarbia, it shifts this curve to the left and oxygen affinity is increased. Therefore, the supply of oxygen to the fetus, it decreases and this might result in fetal hypoxia. So the uterine contractions or the pain because of this, it is not only uncomfortable for the mother, but because of the mother is hyperventilating, it might lead to fetal hypoxia also. So why not give the analgesia and prevent the labor pain? Okay, analgesia, it is the desirable characteristics of labor analgesia is it is safety to the mother and fetus, both of them. It should be effective and controllable. ठीक है, हाई टेक्निकल सक्सेस रेट शुड बी देयर, बट इस एनल्जीजिया से यूट्राइन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन और द मोटर पावर ऑफ द लेडी टू पुश द बेबी आउट शुड नॉट बी हैम्पर्ड। सो इट शुडंट वीक इन द यूट्राइन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन एंड ऑल्सो शुडंट ऑल्टर द प्रोग्रेस ऑफ लेबर एंड डिलीवरी एंड इट शुड नॉट डिप्रेस द फीटस। ठीक है, फीटस को डिप्रेशन नहीं होना चाहिए एंड इट शुड नॉट इंटरफेयर विद मोटिलिटी। सो लेबर एनर्जीज़ हम लोग दे तो रहे हैं, अगर दे रहे हैं तो उसके सिर्फ पॉजिटिव इफेक्ट्स होने चाहिए। ठीक है, इट शुड नॉट हैम्पर विद द प्रोग्रेशन ऑफ द लेबर। it should not hamper with the uterine contractions, or it should not depress the fetal activities. तो इसलिए आजकल लेबर एनल्जीजिया, ठीक है, लेबर एनल्जीजिया विद द एपिड्यूरल एनल्जीजिया, ठीक है, लेबर एनल्जीजिया के डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स हैं. और आजकल नाउ अ डेज द रीजनल एनेस्थीजिया, रीजनल एनल्जीजिया सॉरी दैट इज द एपिड्यूरल एनल्जीजिया इज द मोस्ट कॉमन पॉपुलर मेथड ऑफ पेन रिलीफ ड्यूरिंग द लेबर. ठीक है, रीजनल में भी एपिड्यूरल, ठीक है, एपिड्यूरल एनल्जीजिया, इसका दूसरा नाम है लेबर एनल्जीजिया, ठीक है, या फिर एक और नाम है वॉकिंग एपिड्यूरल. व्हाई वॉकिंग एपिड्यूरल बिकॉज दिस इज अफेक्टिंग only the sensory level, sensory pathway, ठीक है, and in regional analgesia the motor pathway is intact, okay, so the lady is able to mobilize, वो easily walk कर सकती है. The uterine contractions are not hampered. There is no hampering of the progression of the labor. It is just taking care of the sensory pathway, and therefore the lady experiences less pain. ठीक है? तो regional anesthesia के currently the most popular method of pain during labor, most effective and least depressant method of pain relief. And it offers great versatility in extent and duration of the effect. ठीक है? It provides pain relief while allowing the parturient to be awake and be able to participate in the labor and delivery. This is very important. And this is also very important. Epidural analgesia, it doesn't produce drug-induced depression either in the fetus or the mother. ठीक है, एंड द मोस्ट कॉमन विच वी आर यूजिंग एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर दैट इज एपिड्यूरल एनल्जीजिया. ठीक है, एपिड्यूरल एनल्जीजिया इट विल प्रोवाइड कंप्लीट एनल्जीजिया फॉर बोथ द स्टेजेस. ठीक है, फॉर बोथ द स्टेजेस एंड एपिड्यूरल में देयर विल बी बोथ सेफालिक एंड कॉर्डेड स्प्रेड ऑफ द लोकल एनेस्थेटिक. ठीक है, now most commonly mid lumbar midline placement mein isme kya hota hai, it is blocking the T10 to L1 segments also. ठीक है, T1 to L1 segments which is needed to block to relieve pain of uterine contraction and cervical dilatation, and also S2 S4 segments to be blocked to relieve pain of vaginal and perineal distension. So it is taking care of both of them. ठीक है, therefore epidural analgesia is very helpful, and this is the most popular method for labor analgesia which is used nowadays. ठीक है, now so why epidural analgesia is very important, because उसमें क्यों motor component ठीक है is saved, that is because of the sensitivity of the nerve fiber is different to local anesthetics. As discussed earlier, there are three nerve fibers depending upon the diameter and the myelination. Okay, and myelination, jo type A fibers hote hain, theek hai, they are large and they are myelinated. ठीक है, एंड दीज आर द वंस, ठीक है, विच आर इन टर्न डिवाइडेड इनटू ए अल्फा ए बीटा ए गामा ए डेल्टा. ठीक है, ए डेल्टा, ए अल्फा जो होता है ये मोटर फाइबर्स को कैरी करता है, एंड दिस इज द लीस्ट सेंसिटिव टू द लोकल एनेस्थेटिक. बी जो होता है ये प्री गैंग्लियोनिक सिंपैथेटिक फाइबर्स होते हैं विच आर मीडियम एंड पार्शली माइलिनेटेड ये सबसे पहले जाते हैं, ठीक है। सी फाइबर्स दीज आर पेन एंड टेम्परेचर, दीज आर स्मॉल बट दे आर नॉन माइलिनेटेड। तो द सेंसिटिविटी इज बी सी एंड लास्ट में ए, बिकॉज दिस ए फाइबर्स दे आर लार्ज डायमीटर, देयरफॉर इफ आई एम रिड्यूसिंग द कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ द लोकल एनेस्थेटिक इट वोंट पेनिट्रेट इन टू द ए फाइबर्स एंड द मोटर कॉम्पोनेंट विल बी इंटैक्ट बट द सेंसरी एंड द ऑटोनॉमिक कॉम्पोनेंट विल बी gone and therefore the lady won't experience any pain. So this is because of the sensitivity of the nerve fibers to the local anesthetic that epidural analgesia is working. Okay, now for the cesarean section ke liye, depending upon the indication, okay, we can give either regional anesthesia, usme bhi mostly spinal anesthesia diya jata hai, or we can give the general anesthesia, okay? So for the cesarean section mostly we are giving the spinal anesthesia with mostly heavy bupivacaine, but as told earlier the dose is reduced, ठीक है, अराउंड 2 to 2.5 ml ऑफ हैवी बुपिवैकेन इज सफिशियंट टू ब्रिंग अबाउट द एनेस्थीजिया, द एनेस्थेटिक इफेक्ट, ठीक है। एंड इन सिजेरियन सेक्शन वी नीड द सेंसरी ब्लॉकेट लेवल टिल द टी फोर एंड as told earlier the dosage of the drug is reduced in case of the regional anesthesia in cesarean section because the gravid uterus it is compressing upon the IVC reducing the CSF volume space and therefore more chances of cephalate spread, therefore the dose should be reduced. Okay, now what this was the regional anesthesia may other important point we have to keep in mind is the lady should lie in lateral decubitus disposition or a wedge should be placed under right hip while giving anesthesia to prevent supine hypotension syndrome. ठीक है, तो ये बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है, ये बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है. This should be taken care of and the complications and the technique is same as we saw in spinal anesthesia, regional anesthesia ki class mein the complications which are associated with regional anesthesia. So that's why I'm not discussing here. Now the possible indications for the general anesthesia for cesarean section is if the fetus is in distress and we cannot wait for the regional anesthesia to work and therefore we have to be very fast, and that is one of the indication for general anesthesia or for the manual removal of the placenta, like a replacement of the inverted uterus, or if hemorrhagic conditions like placenta previa or accreta and abruptio placenta, in these cases also mostly the cesarean section is happening under general anesthesia, not in regional anesthesia, because regional anesthesia can itself cause hypotension and aggravate the complications. Okay, and also in the umbilical cord prolapse as the fetus is in distress, we need to be fast and quick, and therefore it is one of the indications for general anesthesia. Now in the pregnant ladies there are certain precautions which should be taken during general anesthesia. This I have already discussed previously. See, to prevent First is always in pregnant ladies, prevention of supine hypotension syndrome, and this can be prevented by the lateral decubitus position, okay, decubitus position or the wedge under right hip. Okay, wedge under right hip to prevent the gastric aspiration of the gastric contents. First RSI. ठीक है, उससे भी पहले एंटासिड्स शुड बी गिवन एंड फास्टिंग शुड बी कंप्लीट. एंटासिड शुड बी गिवन, RSI सेलिक्स मैन्यूवर, ठीक है, मैन्यूवर शुड बी डन टू प्रिवेंट द एस्पिरेशन ऑफ द गैस्ट्रिक कंटेंट्स. एंड एज दे आर मोर प्रोन फॉर एयरवे ट्रॉमा, द लैरिंगोस्कोपी, ठीक है, should be gentle and use ETT of smaller size. ठीक है, so these are the certain precautions which should be taken during GA. Last but not the least, all the inhalational anesthetic agents, they have tocolytic effect. So make sure that the agents are used in a proper concentration and dosage, and make sure there is no signs of postpartum hemorrhage. The oxytocin should be given in time, and if the uterus is atonic, we can give methergin. Okay, so these are the precautions which should be taken care during the general anesthesia, especially while giving anesthesia to the pregnant ladies. Is it clear? So this was all about the obstetric anesthesia. The labor analgesia is very important, the epidural analgesia. Also the physiological changes of pregnancy, how it affects the anesthetic drugs, okay, and the procedure, that is very important. So that was all for today's class. Thank you. Thank you.